in processing my internship site. Two sites. I'm painting and I'm really grateful to be out here. What I have to say about that is, my internship has been a weird experience. I don't know if weird is the right word, but I'm at Golden Willow 2 times a week, co-facilitating that group, and I'm also at Valencia Shelter Services out in Las Lunas, and they have a shelter. And I am really grateful for that site. And you know, they work with people who have experienced abuse. And I have been going to the shelter and making art with the women there and the kids, which has been cool. There's a lot that I can say about that. I've also been meeting with 2 girls at the main offices and basically listening to them talk while they paint. I mean, they paint and talk and I listen and watch them. In Golden Willow is this grief group, and people come when they're in grief, when they're grieving, and they can talk about it. And a lot of what people say is about how there's really no space to talk about it in our normal society. And it's not really something, you know, that, yeah, there's not room. There's not appropriate spaces in normal life to talk about what they're experiencing and feeling, and it's really all they want to talk about, and so they can talk about it in that group, and it seems to be really helpful for people. So, as far as my thoughts go, I don't know what to say. It's hard to put it into words. Now I'm going to talk about my internship. It's like I don't have words. Maybe it's just about my feelings in general. That's really hard to put into words. I haven't made my painting yet for this time, but I will soon. Just experimenting. I'm out here in Bosque del Apache, the forest of the Apaches, and I'm processing my internship here, which is, this is just what I love to do, and I feel so good being in places like this. I'm so grateful to be here and to be in places like this. It's so beautiful. And I do think that this project is interweaving with my internship. There was a woman in the Golden Willow group who was really struggling, and she was just breaking down in the group. And then I was thinking about her when I was out, I guess a couple times ago, when I was out in nature, when I was out in White Rock at the Red Dot Blue Dot Trail. I was thinking about how much peace being in nature gives me, and how grateful I am, and how I just feel so loved and held by the earth when I'm in nature, when I'm out in nature. And I was thinking about her, and I was wanting that for her. And then the following week, I talked in the group about how I'd been going out to the Red Dot Blue Dot Trail, and how held I feel, and how loved by nature I feel. And there's this big smile on her face. She said, I love that you said that, Suzanne, because I have a spot that I love to go to, and I feel that way. And I've been saying that to the mountains, like, you're my friend. This is my friend. You know, she said, I'm not crazy. There's someone else who feels this way too. So my time in nature for this capstone project is definitely leading into the internship. The sound of sandhill cranes. So that's a plus. Otherwise, I feel like I'm failing. I really don't like the office environment. I feel nauseous, actually. Like, I just feel this aversion to anything office-y. I just, like, can't deal. Meetings. There's, like, a lingo around that kind of vibe. Vibe. Snowing. I think it's February 6th today. I'm at the top of the ski mountain and it's snowing up here. Family therapy session on Wednesday, and I was really nervous at first when I first realized that I was gonna do that. I was really nervous, and it ended up being really beautiful and heartwarming and touching to do that session, and I wasn't expecting it necessarily to be that way. You know, before I knew it, all three of them were crying and I was almost crying. It really opened my heart. I walked away from that session feeling really blessed by it and feeling really just kind of in awe of how beautiful it can be to be facilitating something like that.